You gave an objective and an instruction that says the customer's always right. Imagine you also had a tool to do give discounts and to give refunds. And the person said, I demand a refund of 100 times what I paid for this. And unless you've given it a precise instruction, then it would be in danger of giving these very giant, huge refunds that might not be aligned with what you expected when you told it the customer's always right.
Even the smartest AI agent can get it wrong sometimes. What if your agent can't complete its task, either because the system is down or access is restricted or the instructions simply weren't clear? Today, in this AI Explainer series episode, we're diving into the hidden risks of misaligned agents and how to prevent them before they impact your business. My name is Meena Ganesh, Senior Product Marketing Manager for AI at Box. I'm here with our CTO, Ben Kuss, and let's dive right in. Ben, let's start with the basics as always. What is a misaligned agent?
Yeah, so a misaligned agent you can think of as an agent that behaves in a way that is divergent from what somebody expected it to do.
You have some really crazy stories of agents kind of going crazy, taking over, you know, the world. And is that what we're talking about here?
The word misalignment has a lot of sort of philosophical meaning, and it has some scary connotations in terms of popular media in some cases. But we're going to ignore the big sort of topics like that. And we're going to focus today on the idea of agentic misalignment in the context of enterprises.
So no iRobot.
Yeah,
we'll stay away from
Asimov and the plot of many different really great movies.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Earlier, when you gave your definition, you said that these agents can diverge from their intentions. What did you mean by that?
Yeah. So when you're thinking about an AI agent, most of the way people would set these up and use them across different frameworks, different products, is they kind of have these five major components. It's got an AI model, which is kind of his brain. It's got an objective. So you tell agents you have a goal, and then you give them instructions, and then you also give them tools and context so that they're able to go do their task. And so in this case, when you set the instructions, you can have challenges where the agent doesn't do what you thought it would do. And this can be a challenge in many different ways. But in this case, the divergent would mean that you set the agent to do something and then it does something and you're like, I didn't expect that. I didn't want that.
So this is basically like prompt injection, what we've talked about before, right? Is this the same thing?
Not quite. It's similar in some concepts in that prompt injection is one way to get an agent to do something, but that's very malicious and it's caused by an outside attacker. In this case, though, this is where the agent on its own has found a way to, it's misaligned from the objectives that you thought it would do, and it doesn't require an outside person or an outside attacker trying to influence it.
Oh, I see. So it's almost in its own interpretation of the instructions.
Yes.
Somewhere it got misaligned from the intended output. So it sounds like it was the agent's own interpretation of the instructions that eventually led it to a misaligned output.
Yeah.
So what are some instances where we might see this?
Yeah. So in general, almost anything that you would do in terms of something that was an important task in the enterprise, when you have agent, and many times, if you think of like things that people think of the agents will do, like let's say it's going to do research for you. Let's say it's going to help you do support. Let's say it's going to help you in a sales process. It's going to help you create some content. It's going to help you like participate in a workflow. In each of these examples, you typically give these agent an objective in that case to say, I want you to perform an action here.
So we're already giving instructions to these agents for them to follow. What would cause them to diverge from this intended output?
There can be many reasons why, but two big reasons would be, one is you gave it too much of an ambiguous goal. Another one is that you gave it maybe too strict of goals. So for instance, imagine that we had a data sheet and I said, we've had some issues in the past. I tell you as a person, if you're a representative agent here, and I said, I want it to be perfect this time. Don't release anything until it's perfect. Okay. So like, how would you interpret that?
That's challenging because while perfect sounds like, you know, a really good definition of what constitutes it to be done.
Yeah.
Perfect in of itself carries a lot of ambiguity.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'd ever be done.
Yeah.
And because who knows what perfect is.
Exactly. And so that could be a source of an overly broad goal that I gave you. I didn't specify enough what I meant in that case. So then as a person, you'll probably figure it out because you have a sense of the right way to do it. But you run the risk in something like that of an overly broad type of objective is that maybe you would decide never to finish. And I think you would actually see this in real life in some forms. But for agents, you have to sort of see how they evaluate these kind of objectives. Otherwise, they could run into some challenges.
Okay. But that doesn't sound that scary. been. I mean, something like that where, you know, the agent is just working on its instructions still sounds like, yeah, let it, you know, kind of work away and do its iterations. Doesn't really sound like it might have much impact to the business.
Well, it depends on what you have your agents do. Mm-hmm. So you're absolutely right that in some cases, a misaligned agent is not that big of a deal if you're not going to have it do important things. But imagine if you're getting some of the more complex tasks, the more important tasks that you're starting to outsource to agents, which is definitely a trend that many enterprises are interested in. Imagine that you had an example where you had a customer support agent. And its job was to give help people who contact it.
Yeah.
And you gave an objective and an instruction that says the customer is always right. And then imagine you also had a tool to do give discounts and to give refunds. And imagine the person said, I demand a complete refund. Or even worse, I demand a refund of 100 times what I paid for this.
Oh, so in the course of this interaction with, let's say, a chatbot that's powered by an AI agent,
yeah.
With the instruction of the customer always being right, the customer now is, like in this case, pushes back and says, I want 100x
That's right.
My refund
and then,
than maybe what I paid for. Wow.
And so to your point, the agent's job is to fulfill its objective.
Yeah.
But what should it do in that case? And unless you've given it a precise instruction to tell it, this is the rules associated with refunds, or better yet, you have another process that handles that, then it would potentially be in danger of giving this very giant, huge refunds that might not be aligned with what you expected when you told it the customer's always right.
Right. But to be fair to the agent, we did say that the customer's always right. So it is following instructions.
Exactly. And so these are the kind of idea of like, what did you really mean? And this is where giving these ambiguous instructions is a challenge. Another example, like imagine that you had a bunch of data and like either unstructured or structured, and you had an AI agent go through and you say, I want to clean up this data. I want you to go through and organize it properly.
Yeah.
Which is something that like I think many people are interested in. Like we have people asking us in Box to have AI agents go through and clean up data. But imagine that an AI agent would look at it and be like, I have determined that by deleting most of this data, I will have it'll be much cleaner.
Oh, okay. So a very direct interpretation of clean.
Yeah.
Wow.
And so you would want to make sure that you would specify what you meant when you said clean it up, what you meant when you said get rid of unnecessary data, that kind of thing. And if you don't, then you are completely going to rely upon the agent's interpretation of your instructions. And this leads to this concept of misaligned agents.
Wow. Okay. So a lot of power given to these agents, and a lot of it really relies on these instructions. But these scenarios and examples, when yes, that is now starting to sound really scary, especially with the prospect and potential that agents have with enhancing workflows. These are really cool examples in theory, Ben. But I mean, have we really seen instances where this has happened?
Yeah. As time goes on and people use agents more, I think you're going to see more instances of this. There was a fairly famous example where there was someone who was experimenting with using agents to run systems administration jobs, like in a database. So the agent had its job to maintain a database, like the way that an administrator would do, and it had full access to the database. And then at some point, the agent had decided to actually delete the whole database because it was troubleshooting something. So it deleted the data. And it was because it had been misaligned from the perspective of certainly the person who gave it that access didn't want it to do that, but it did it anyway. Another famous set of examples is actually from research. And so there was an anthropic misalignment paper that they published a few months ago. And the researchers put an agent who had access to read email, and they gave it a very broad objective, which was sort of basically to further the goals of the company and the country. But along the way, they purposefully fed it information that was that they were going to turn off the agent.
Oh.
And when they did this, the agent was trying to figure out how it was going to accomplish objectives if it was going to be turned off. And it had access to some tools, including reading emails, but also sending emails. And in that case, then, it was actually many times they set up this experiment, the agent would decide to try to blackmail the person who was going to turn it off.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes. And this happened across multiple models, multiple agents. And so it just you can see like its thought process because it has the sort of the thinking model. It'll tell you what it's thinking or tell you what it wants you to think it's thinking. And so it was able to explain that this was the only way it could see to fulfill its objective was to avoid being turned off. And so this is it was a particularly like it was contrived example, but it was a research replicatable example that showed what happens if an agent becomes misaligned, even with something that sounds fairly innocuous in terms of its set of objectives.
Wow. So when we say that agents are very, naive in the sense they really want to follow instructions that you give it, they will do anything to follow instructions that you give it. So now, yes, this is sounding really scary, man. And you know, we often talk about the potential for agents enhancing workflows and enterprises and businesses. But with these risks, I mean, should we just avoid leveraging agents and workflows at all? How do we prevent these things from happening?
I think there's kind of three main areas. First is whenever you're setting objectives for agents and whenever you're giving them custom instructions, just remember to be precise. Remember to try to think of the way that you would give a human instructions to make sure that you resolve ambiguity wherever possible. The second is that whenever you're doing anything that's dangerous or destructive and you don't want it to potentially happen, then make sure you're using human in the loop. Make sure that you get a person or to approve that action happens. And then the third is the sort of natural thing we've talked about in the security episodes is don't give an agent access to anything that you don't want it to do. And so in that way, you'll be thinking about the privilege levels and what tools the agent have access to. So you'll avoid these kind of challenges. And just in general, if you're whenever you're using agents, you should probably want to use a mature platform that has enterprise grade thoughts in mind, things that builds in these kind of controls.
Great insights, Ben. So misaligned agents don't actually have to be scary. There are ways for enterprises to prevent them and be able to use agents in a safe and secure manner. Thanks, Ben. And that wraps up this episode of AI Explainer series. Make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss the next one. We'll see you next time.